Queensland politics has been tipped upside down. Opposition leader John-Paul Langbroek is out, replaced by Campbell Newman, who's not even in the state parliament. And the Premier is refusing to rule out a snap election. In a moment, Leonie Millar will tell how this leaves City Hall. Ursula Hager has reaction in the seat Campbell Newman hopes to win. But first to Cathy Border at state parliament. And Cathy, what an extraordinary day.
Sure has been, Bill. Queensland has seen some radical political campaigns over the years. Joe for PM, Peter Beattie on the listening tour, swimming with sharks. Now we can add the Campbell coup. Campbell Newman wants Anna Bligh's job and he's not even in the Queensland Parliament. It's absolutely amazing. The Premier has already broken her promise that 2011 would be a rebuilding year, not an election year, and has effectively put us on campaign footing already. The pre-selection for Campbell Newman in Ashgrove will be sorted early next week, either Monday or Tuesday. Now, the way that this has all played out today, for the Conservatives, it's been such a high-risk strategy, it will either backfire or be brilliant.
Unprecedented behind-the-scenes manoeuvring opened a new political door for Campbell Newman today.
Not make any comment this morning. Come to the press conference later on, 10:30.
10:30?
At the exact time the state opposition leader was questioning the government, Mr Newman took his job, announcing a run for state politics.
I intend to nominate for pre-selection for the state seat of Ashgrove. Should I be successful in gaining pre-selection with the Liberal National Party, it's then my intention to resign the Lord Mayoralty and to then launch a leadership challenge for the leadership of the state LNP team.
It was extraordinary. Not even a member of the Queensland Parliament, Campbell Newman was already offering John-Paul Langbroek a job.
Because I do really genuinely like John-Paul Langbroek and I feel he has ability, I would like him to consider, if this all happens, being a member of the front bench.
As LNP members in the chamber came to terms with the Campbell coup, the government was having a field day.
We'll go through every question time, Mr Speaker, without...
Jeff Seeney gave the government a sneak peek of what was coming. Just 90 minutes later, Mr Langbroek fell on his sword.
I will stand aside today as Leader of the Opposition. It's a treacherous business.
His deputy also quit Shadow Cabinet, recalling why the LNP was formed.
I did so to make sure that we had one leader, not two.
At an LNP meeting tonight, Jeff Seeney will be elected opposition leader, but only in name. Campbell Newman is in charge.
Campbell's in it for Queensland, and I'm with Campbell all the way.
So if Mr Newman doesn't win, but the LNP wins the election, who becomes Premier?
If the LNP wins and Campbell doesn't,
yes.
Oh, that's getting into silly stuff. But...
An election could be soon, Premier Bligh claiming the LNP's made Parliament a farce.
I rule nothing in and nothing out today.
Cathy Border, 10 News.
The confusion doesn't end at state parliament. Leonie Mellor is at City Hall. And Leonie, the state opposition leader is effectively also the Lord Mayor of Brisbane. Is that the situation?
Yes, Georgie, it's bizarre. As we speak, Campbell Newman is tonight in the City Council chambers just adjacent the square here at a City Council meeting. Look, the move didn't come as a complete surprise to his team or to the councillors, but the final stages in which the speed with which he made that final decision certainly was something of a shock. Now, Campbell Newman will remain as Lord Mayor until he gets that pre-selection. Then it will be up to the councillors with its LNP majority to decide who replaces him.
It looked just like any other Tuesday City Council meeting, except it wasn't.
Campbell Newman is no longer interested in what he can do for Brisbane residents.
Campbell Newman's team still absorbing the news. He intends to cast aside his mayoral robes for a tilt at state politics.
I don't do anything other than call it the way I see it for Brisbane, and that's what I'll do for Queensland.
Councillor Newman maintains he only made the decision last night and told his team this morning.
Yes, it's all been fairly sudden, but no, we're right behind him.
Will you be putting your hand up for the new Lord Mayoralty position?
Campbell Newman will make a great Premier of Queensland.
Ray Smith, Labor's Lord Mayoral contender, is wrapped.
The people of Brisbane have every right to be absolutely incensed at this betrayal.
But the first step for Councillor Newman is winning pre-selection, then the bigger goal, challenging for the LNP leadership.
but nobody's made any commitments or any promises to me whatsoever.
If Campbell Newman does win pre-selection, he'll immediately resign as Lord Mayor, paving the way for a new face to lead the city.
The man most likely, 25-year veteran Graham Quirk.
I'm young, I'm energetic, and I'm ready to serve.
Sounds like an application for the job.
Oh, I'll be in there, thank you.
But it will be up to the LNP councillors to decide. If the unthinkable happens and Councillor Newman isn't successful, he intends to remain as Lord Mayor.
Breathtaking arrogance, and clearly this Lord Mayor is treating the residents of Brisbane as second prize.
For Councillor Newman, it's the next step in a political dynasty. Both his parents were federal ministers. He'll lodge his notice for pre-selection tomorrow. Leonie Mellor, 10 News.
Now let's look at that seat of Ashgrove. Ursula Hager joins us from the heart of it. Ursula.
Yes, Bill, Campbell Newman used to live in the seat, and as he pointed out today, both of his daughters went to dance classes here. Labor's Kate Jones holds the seat by more than 3,000 votes, but the Lord Mayor has a solid start. Much of the seat is made up of the Gap, and people here have high praise for the job Campbell Newman did during the disastrous Gap storms.
It will be the most watched seat at the next election. Campbell Newman targeting the West Brisbane electorate of Ashgrove for his first tilt at state politics. He admits it won't be an easy win despite a recent popularity boost from the floods and his strong local leadership during the Gap storms.
Because I want to serve the people of Ashgrove, I've had a long association with that community. I only live 2.5 kilometres outside the boundary. It's actually the hardest seat to win on paper.
A shocked Kate Jones, the current MP for Ashgrove, found out while sitting in Parliament. But she intends to take the challenge head on.
I'm not going to stand by and let Campbell Newman use the people of Ashgrove as a stepping stone for his own political ambition.
Ashgrove locals were today just getting used to the idea Brisbane's Lord Mayor could become their next state MP.
I think Kate's got a very big following. It's going to be a difficult task, and probably he had to pick that, I guess. But I think he's got a formidable opponent in Kate Jones as well.
I think he'll be fantastic, and he's got my vote every time.
I just think it's opportunistic. He's doing a fine job where he is. He should stay there.
I don't like him, so it's it.
Ashgrove has been in Labor's hands for more than 20 years and is not considered to be an easy seat to win for an LNP candidate.
Environment Minister Kate Jones first won the seat of Ashgrove in 2006. She holds it with a margin of 3,700 votes, meaning Campbell Newman would need to create a 7% swing to take the seat from her.
The battle is just beginning. Ursula Hager, 10 News.